You are taking the second year, second semester, third lesson, Upadesamrutam. Sri Samudrala Lakshmanaya written this lesson. Kavi Sri Samudrala Lakshmanasya మూలగ్రంథం మలయాళ యతీంద్రస్య ఉపదేశామృతం. శ్రీ సముద్రాల లక్ష్మయ్య వాజ్ బార్న్ ఇన్ 1939 ఇన్ ద విలేజ్ కటకాలయకుంట ఇన్ చిత్తూర్ డిస్ట్రిక్ట్. ఈ స్టడీడ్ ఎట్ సాంస్క్రిట్ స్కూల్ ఇన్ Erpedu and Oriental College. Tirupati, the college is in Tirupati. He received the degree of Sahitya Siromani from Sri Venkateswara University. He worked in SV Oriental College. Tirupati as a lecturer. He was the deputy secretary of Hindu Dharma Prachara Parishat for 7 years. He worked as the special officer in the Bhagavata project of TTD, that is Tirupati Devasthanam. Presently, he is the special offer in TTD's Purana Itihasa projects. Now, the present lesson is an extract from the Malayala Yatindrasya Upadesamrutam, which has 17 verses. The present lesson has 22 selected verses from that work. Sri Malayala Swami was born as Velappa in Kerala. He became a disciple of Sri Sudha Jivalinga and performed finance. He started a Sanskrit school in Erpedu in Chittoor district. Sri Samudrala Lakshmaya penned his Sahitya Shas Upadesamrutam. But this is only the story for the Nagarjuna University students, but for not for us. Now, now the fourth lesson are taken. Now, for the students of our college, పుష్పోద్భవ చరితం రచయిత దండి, మూలగ్రంథం దశకుమార చరిత్రం. prose kavyas are less in number in Sanskrit literature. You know, in Sanskrit literature, so many books are written by as slokas, as the poets felt that it was difficult to write pleasing prose. But it was difficult to write pleasing prose. They performed the method poetry to the unchained prose. Hence, the adage, Gadhyam Kavinam Nikasham Vadanti. That is, prose is the touchstone for poets. Dandini was the foremost of the prose authors of Sanskrit. He was praised as Kavidandi, Kavidandi, Kavidandi. Dandi alone is a poet in prose. But Dandini was the great grandson of poet Bharavi. His father Veeradatta was a great philosopher. His mother Gauri was also a scholar. He lived on the first half of the 7th century AD in the city of Kanchi. As he was a renunciate and held a staff, he was called Dandin. Dandini authored three literary books, among them Avanti Sundarakanta and Dasakumara Charitra, and as prose kavyas and Kavyadhara Andarsa is a work in literary criticism. Dandini had a pleasing and flowing literary style. He was famous for the sweet words he used. Dandinaha Padalalithyam, Dandinaha Padalalithyam. So his words are very sweet to read, and the present lesson is the fourth chapter in the Purva Pitika of the Dasakumara Charitra. This gives an account of the deeds of Pushpodbhava, a friend of Rajavahana. The hero of the story, Pushpodbhava, renunciates with his parents while searching for Rajavahana. Later, he married Balachandrika after rescuing her from the cruel Daruvaraman. This is the about the story of the poet Dandi, but it is very simple. Now we are entering to the lesson what he wrote. ದೇವ ಮಹಿಷುರೋಪಕಾರಾಯೈವ ದೇವೋ ಗತವಾನಿತಿ ನಿಶ್ಚಿತ್ಯಾಪಿ ದೇವೇನ ಗಂತವ್ಯಂ ದೇಶಂ ನಿರ್ದೇತುನು ನಿರ್ದೇತು ಮಸಕ್ನುವಾನೋ ಮಿತ್ರಗಣಃ ಪರಸ್ಪರಂ ವಿಯುಜ್ಯ ದಿಕ್ಷೋ ದೇವಮನ್ವೇಷ್ಟು ಮಗಚ್ಛತ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್? ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಓ ಲಾರ್ಡ್, ಈವೆನ್ ದೋ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೆಜೆಸ್ಟಿ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಟು ಅಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಎ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಿನ್ ಅಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಿನ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಅನೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ವೇರ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾನ್. ದಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಸಪರೇಟೆಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವೆಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫರೆಂಟ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಸೀರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೆಜೆಸ್ಟಿ. ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ ಉಪಕಾರಂ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ದಿ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಿನ್ ಮಾತಂಗ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಹಮಪಿ ದೇವಸ್ಯ ಅನ್ವೇಷಣಾಯ ಮಹೀಮಠಸ್ಕದಾಚಿದಮಂ ಸಿದಂಬರ ಮಧ್ಯ ಗತ ಶ್ಯಾಂಬರಮಣೇ ಕಿರಣ ಮಸಹಿಷ್ಣುರೇಕಚ್ಚ ಗಿರಿತಟ ಮಹೀರುಹಸ್ಯ ಪ್ರಚ್ಛಾಯಶೀಲೆ ಶೀತಲೆ ಥಲೆ ಕ್ಷಣಮುಪಾವಿಶತ್. ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್, ವೆನ್ ರೋಮಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿವೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಸೀರ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೆಜೆಸ್ಟಿ, ಒನ್ ಡೇ ಅನೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಬೇರ್ ದಿ ಹೀಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಮಿಡ್ ಡೇ ಸನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಮ ಪುರೋಭಾಗೆ ದಿನಮಧ್ಯ ಸಂಕುಚಿತ ಸರ್ವಾವಯವಾಂ ಕೂರ್ಮಾಕೃತಿಂ ಮಾನುಷ್ಯಛಾಯಾಂ ನಿರೀಕ್ಷೋನ್ಮುಖೋ ಗಗನತಲಾಸ್ಮಹಾರಣೆ ಸ್ಮರಹಾರಯೇಣ ಪಹತ್ ಪತಂತ ಪತತ್ತಂ ಪುರುಷಂ ಖಚಿದಂತರಾಲ ಏವ ದಯೋಪನತ ಹೃದಯೋ ಈ ಮಹಾವಲಂಭಂ ಶನೈರವನಿಯತಿ ನಿತಲೆ ನಿಕ್ಷಿಪ್ಯ ದುರಾಪಾತ ವೇತಸಂಜ್ಞಂ ತಂ ಶಿಶಿರೋಪಚಾರಣೆ ವಿಭೋಧ್ಯ ಶೋಕಾತಿರೇಕೇಣೋ ಗತಭಾಷ್ಪಲೋಚನಂ ತಂ ಭೃಗುಪತನ ಕಾರಣಮಪೃಚ್ಛಂ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ I rested for a while under the shade of the tree at the foot of a hill. Thereupon, seeing in front of me the shadow of a person, there is a shadow, a person is there under the tree. But that had all the limbs contracted like a tortoise because of it being looked up and with my heart filled with pity. When I am seeing that person, I am very pity because of his position not in good as a man. So I am very, very pity. A great spread of his body. and also having put him down on the ground. But the person is having put him down on the ground, made that unconscious one come to senses by cool administrations and asked him whose eyes were filled with tears owing to heavy anguish, the reason for his fall from the ship. That is, it is very pity for that scene. And also, Sopi Kararuhaira Suk Asrukanana Panayana Bhashata Saumya Magadhadhinadha Matrasya Padhodbhava Smatva Sambhod Sambhavo Ratnodbhavo Namaham. That is, wiping his tears, when he is looking that scenes, wiping his tears with his nails, he answered thus, "O good one, I am Ratnodbhava, the son of Padmodbhava, the minister of the king of the Magadha." He is saying that, like, but afterwards, Vanijya Rupena Kalayavana Dvipa Mupetya Kamapi Vanikanyakam Paraniyataya Saha Pratyagachan Budbhavadau Tirasyanatidhura Eva Pravahanasya Bhagnataya Sarvesu Nimagneshu Kadangatha Mapi Daivanu Kulena Tirabhumi Mapigamya Nijangana Vyoga Vyoga Dukarnavi Plavamanaha Kasyapi Siddhatapa Sasya Desyadaranya Shodasa Hayanani Kadanchitnitva Dukkasya Paramana Anek Kshamanaha Giripatana Makarsham Iti. That is mean, I married, having gone to the island Kalyanavana for the sake of business. For the business, I am going to the Kalyanavana place, island. I married the daughter of some merchant there. And also, while returning with her, because of shipwreck in the sea not far away from the coast, while all others drown with fat being favorable, I somehow reached this shore and plunged into the ocean of grief owing to the separation from my wife, and honoring the word of some mendicant having some house spent 16 years and not finding the end of my agony. I jumped from the ship cliff. That is Kararuhai with males. That is Pravahanam, a ship. Hayanani, but that is ears. As like this, the ship is Varsh. Tasminne vavasana vavasare kimapi nari pujita masrani nakalu samuchitamidam yatpidbhadhishthe patitanayami milane viraha manahishnur vai syavanara vishasi iti. Then I heard a voice of a lady, that is, all that very moment some female voice was heard. It is not proper on your part of enter fire unable to bear the delay in meeting your son and husband as predicated by this sage. Is saying there is a lady trying to enter into the fire. Why? That is, she is not able to bear, unable to bear the delay in meeting your son, her son and husband as predicted by the sage. Is telling that story of that lady. That story is heard the sage. What happened next? That is, so he is telling, oh my lady, it is not good for you, don't enter into the fire. He is saying to her, the sage is saying, Tanni samanya mano vidita janaka bhavam tamavadivam tata bhavate vijnana niyani bahuni vasanti bhavatu pachyadha akhila makhyatavambyam adhuna nari kujita manupekshiniyam maya kshanamatram bhavata sthiyatam iti. That is, on hearing that sound, I, who felt in my heart that he was my father, when I heard that word voice, I think that voice is belongs to the to my father, said to him, Father, there are many things that are to be shared with you. Let them be. Later everything will be told, but now I can't disregard the cry of a woman. Please stay here for a moment. Please, a cry is here by me. A lady is crying. Why she is crying? we are very surprised how she is crying, how what she is doing. I am very surprised. Please wait for here some time. He is telling to his father that tadanu soham twaraya kinchidantarama gamam antaragamam tatra purato ehankara jwala bhayankara jwala kulahuta bhugavagahana sahasikam mukulitanjali putam vanitam kanchadavalokhya sambramamana mama సలాదవనీయా పూజంత వృద్ధయా సహా మత్పితుర్భ్యర్నామభిగమ్య స్థవిరామోక్షం వృద్ధే భవత్యౌ పుత్రత్యే కాంతారే నిమిత్తేన కేన దురవస్థానుసూయతే కథితాం ఇతి. That is, then when he heard that voice is waiting there, and then quickly I ran forward, forward to there. There having seen some lady, he saw a lady there who with folded hands was about to enter the fire that was fire. Some with flames I dragged her hurriedly away from the fire. When he went to there and saw that lady, he dragged her away from that fire. And having conducted her along with the wailing old woman to the presence of my father, then asked the old woman, "O old lady, where are you from? Where you are coming to here? Why you are sitting here?" As like he is questioning and asking, "Why do you experience this worst condition in the forest? Please tell, what happened there? In you are living in this forest from some time. So, in this worst forest, why you are sitting here and getting your life here? Why you tell me? Please tell me." He is asking. Then sa sagadgada మవాధీత్ పుత్ర కాళయవనదీపే కాళగుప్తనామ్నో వణిజ కశ్య సిదేశ సుత సువృత్తనామ రత్నోద్భవేన నిశకాంతేన గచ్చంతి జలధౌ మగ్నే ప్రవహణే నిజధాత్రామయ సహ పులకమేకమవలంభ్య దైవయోగేన కూలముపేత సన్న ప్రసవసమయ కశాంచదట వ్యామాతృ జమమాత మమ ఈ మందభాగ్యతయా బాలే వనమాతంగేన గృహీతే మద్వితీయ పరిభ్రమంతి షోడశ వర్షానంతరం భర్తృపుత్ర సంయోగో భవిష్యతి ఇతి సిద్ధవాక్య విశ్వాస దేకస్మిత్ సూర్యాశ్రమే తావంతం సమయం నీత్వా శోకమపారం సాధుమక్షమ సముజ్వలితే వైశ్వానరే శరీరమాహతిం మాహుతి కర్తుముధ్యాక్తాసీత్ ఇతి. హియర్ she answered for that question of his, she answered with a shocking voice, my son, while this lady Suvrita by name, the daughter of a merchant called Kalagupta belonging to the island of Kalayavana was traveling along with her husband, their ship sank in the sea. So, afterwards, and by her good fortune, she who was pregnant, reaching the shore, catching hold of a plank along with me. Her maid and gave birth to a son in a forest. But because of my ill luck, along with her husband, their ship sank in the sea, and by her good fortune, she who was pregnant, reached the shore, catching hold of a plank along with me. So both we are coming to the seashore, her maid, and gave birth to a son in a forest. But because of my ill luck, as the boy was taken away by a wild elephant. A wild elephant is coming to here and it takes her son away. So, she wandered along with me. Always she is weeping for the son and also the husband. And keeping faith in the words of a Siddha who said, a reunion with your son and husband will happen after 16 years. The sage says to her, oh dear lady, you don't afraid, don't weep, don't expect your ideas. That is, your son and husband meet you after 16 years, he is saying, by these words, spend that much of the time in a sacred hermitage and unable to bear the great grief was prepared to throw her body into the burning fire. The 16 years fulfilled. After 16 years also, she was not able to meet her son and husband. The sage words are failed, she is thinking. So, she is very surprised and also prepared to throw her body into the burning fire. So, no source is there to me, she is thinking. Okay.